Hey guys, welcome back to Bicen Maths. If you're new to the channel, then my name is Mr Bicen and I've been a maths teacher, mostly of A-level maths and further maths, for the last 12 years. And today I wanted to talk to you about the A-level exams for maths and further maths that are coming up in the summer of 2023. And there's a few things in this video that I'm going to go through. First of all, I want to talk to you about just getting started, then some revision tips and tricks. I then want to speak to you about the grade boundaries for 2023, because there's some talk about them being quite different to the last few years. Then I want to mention some revision classes that I'm planning and preparing for right now. And the last thing is just some other projects that I've been working on. So it might feel like exam season is really far away, because this is just coming out about February half term, and exams do feel quite far off. But actually they're not that far away, and suddenly they're going to hit you out of nowhere. So the first thing I want to speak to you about is getting started. The best time to get started with your revision is now. As soon as you finish watching this video, you just need to start making a plan. I think a lot of people feel quite stressed about the exam season, with good reason for it, but the thing that makes it more stressful is procrastinating and putting it off. If you finish watching this video and just go and say, you know what I'm going to do is make a little plan for what I'm going to do this week, you will find yourself in a much less stressful position and your anxiety levels will just be going down as a result. It doesn't mean you have to be in full revision mode just yet, but starting that process off is going to make you feel so much better, particularly as lots of other people in your school are probably going to be doing a similar thing very, very soon now. Now I want to speak to you about the main revision techniques that you should be employing over this period of time. And I usually put it into three categories that roughly come in this order. And that is to understand, to memorize, and to practice. But some of those things are going to overlap a bit. So what do I mean by that? Well, first of all, you need to decide what topics do you not understand at all. This can be looking at a mock paper that you've done. It could be looking at the contents page of a textbook, and just figure out how you're going to understand those. You could use my videos. I have videos on absolutely every chapter of every part of the textbook, all on my channel, all for free. And you could also speak to a teacher, you could speak to a friend, or you could look at notes online, all sorts of things. But make sure that you've figured out which are the topics that you need to understand more fully. The second thing is then going to be about memorizing. There are certain facts that if you memorize, you're going to be in a much stronger position. I talk to my classes about this all the time. Things like memorizing what does sine, cos, tan, sec, cosec, and cot all differentiate to, because it will make you a stronger mathematician. And to help you with that, I've got some videos on my channel that are about everything that you need to memorize for maths, for pure, statistics, mechanics, and there's even some there for further maths as well. They have some PDFs that come with them that you can fill in. You can print these off, have them stuck on your wall. That's what I found my classes in the past have really benefited from. And then the last thing, which is probably the most important one, is practice. And when we talk about practicing, we need to think about what it is that you're actually going to be doing. Obviously, you can use the things from the textbooks, but I'm going to talk to you a lot more about exam questions and exam technique here. For the practice style of questions, anytime that you're doing a full paper, you want to look at the number of marks that there are and multiply it by 1.2 for the number of minutes that you should have. I recommend just doing that in a normal coloured pen, and then when you get to the end of your time limit, don't just give up, then switch to a different coloured pen so that when you look at your work, you can decide, actually, how far did I get in the allotted time? It will also help you with time management, because you'll be reflecting on how long things are taking. Then when you finish that, switch to another coloured pen and go to the mark schemes and mark your work. This is the part that I think is the most important. If you're going to be marking your work and you just look at a mark scheme and copy it out, that isn't really learning. So really try and understand what it is that is going through there. And then the most important part is to either take a screenshot of that question, take a picture of that question, and put it in a folder on your phone or on your device or your computer, where you will return to those questions in about 2 or 3 weeks' time and you reattempt them. When you attempt them again in a couple of weeks, if they're fine, then that's great. Looking through the mark scheme helped. But if not, you're going to need to return to that one again and again until you've got it. Now, people sometimes think, isn't this just rote learning, like how to do a particular question? And it isn't, because in 2 or 3 weeks' time, you probably won't just have the memory of how it worked. But if you can do it again, it's because you understood the concept that was being explored in that particular question. So I recommend that technique. Please, please use that. It's going to be very, very successful for you. The next thing that I wanted to speak to you about was then, what do you do if you're not doing full papers? Well, you can use my exam question document that is in my Google Drive. These have all been updated, including 2021. And just remember, multiply the number of marks by 1.2 for the number of minutes that you should have. So if you've already downloaded those, make sure you go back and re-download them, because they've all been fully updated. Then I wanted to speak to you about the grade boundaries in 2023. Well, Ofqual and the government have confirmed that in 2023, we are returning to pre-pandemic grading. So in other words, like the grade boundaries that we would have seen in 2019. Now, that does mean they're going to have increased from the boundaries you would have seen in 2022. But if you look back at 2019, the grade boundaries aren't that high, but that's because it was a particularly challenging year. Those papers were regarded by me especially as some of the toughest that there have been. And so I think they've started making the papers a little bit more accessible since then. So I would imagine the grade boundaries to be around 2019, if not a little bit higher. They've also said something here that I wanted to read out. They've said that because of the impact of the pandemic on your particular cohort, they're trying to still support students with this. They've said that, broadly speaking, therefore, a typical student who would have achieved a grade A in their A-level before the pandemic will be just as likely to get an A next summer, even if their performance in the assessments is a little weaker in 2023 than it would have been before the pandemic. So this sounds to me like there's going to be some leniency with the grade boundaries, and perhaps they won't be exactly the same as they were in 2019, but I definitely think it's in your interests to make sure that you're pushing as hard as you can so that you're not on the cusp, but that you are sort of far into that grade that you need it to be. Then I wanted to mention about some revision classes. I've been thinking about running some revision classes alongside the free videos that I give away, something that might be for smaller groups of people, and was wondering if that was something that people would be interested in. It would be for an online kind of class, so it doesn't matter where you are, and I'd probably think about running one over the Easter holidays and one in the May holiday just before the exam starts. At this point, I just kind of want to figure out what these might look like, what kind of thing that you guys would be interested in. So at the top of the description, I've got a link to a Google form where you can sign up to hear updates from me, and you'll be the first to hear about any classes that I'm going to offer. And on that form, there's also going to be a place where you can request what you might find useful, particular topics or particular formats, as well as any other comments that you might have about this. I'll also notify everyone on my channel as well, but if you sign up, you're going to be the first to hear about it. And as there's going to be some limited numbers, it'll mean you'll be in a position to be able to get one of the places on the revision class. The last thing I'd like to talk to you about is what other projects I've been working on, and I've been working on a different channel, which is my Bicen Maths GCSE channel. I would love it if you could share it with a friend, a classmate, someone who's doing their GCSEs, because I've been putting a lot of time in to try and answer tons and tons of different styles of questions. My recent project is answering every exam question on particular topics that have been asked. So if you've got anyone who's doing their GCSEs and you've enjoyed my teaching style, please do recommend it, because it would be very, very helpful. And you guys could also go along there and subscribe and just kind of help get it off the ground. I would be very, very grateful of that. Anyway, that's everything from me for now. There's going to be more updates over the coming months, so do make sure that you're subscribed to my channel. Share this with any friends who might be starting to stress about exams, because it's not meant to be a stressful thing. The sooner you get started, the better. Which leads me on to my very final point. Get off YouTube now and go and start your revision plan. Good luck.